Hey, what's up, everybody? Today we're back recording a video that I've been excited about for a while. We're going to show you how to build datasets and create lists from internet information, including the web scraper, formatting the data, downloading it, researching it, everything. We're going to do it in a way that anyone can have an organized dataset list from a web scrape in 2 minutes. We're going to be using the tool PromptLoop for this, and everything we do in this video is available right now, including our free plan. If you have specific questions, please get in touch, and I hope you find this as interesting as I did. So first, I want to talk about what we're going to do. We work with customers and see clients on our platform build interesting lists from internet data that might already be aggregated in a bunch of places. This could be a list of addresses on a restaurant. This could be a list of names on a website or a company directory. In this specific example, we're going to be looking at lists of physicians on medical and university page websites. So if you're looking to aggregate data from different sources into one list that you can use for your business, for your product, for your growth plans, or anything you want to do with the information, what we're going to come out with is one data set with formatted information based on what we can find on the internet. Your alternative is certainly going through page by page and writing down all this information one by one. But the beauty of PromptLoop is that we can do all of this with one simple task, simply uploading a list of websites and getting back all the data we could ever ask for. As I said, we're going to be using PromptLoop to accomplish all of this. If you open a new account, you'll see a task page that will start with a blank task. So in this case, I have my scrape list for doctor's task already loaded. If you don't have a task loaded or want to get started, you'll want something general. So you can simply click New Task, Copy from Template, and the tasks we're looking at today are list building tasks. We're going to a website, finding a specific link, and extracting from it something from it. If I just simply click this, the system is going to automatically create and copy and generate an AI task that can go out and find lists for you. You see this new one is copied and ready to be tested here. If we wanted to edit this, we can click Edit Task and change the specific columns that things are looking for. The dummy template is looking for names, titles, and phone numbers. You could change this to whatever the list of information you have and what columns you want. If you were looking, for example, business addresses, you could look for city, state, telephone number, and then anything else like a link to the page. And if the models can't find that information, they're simply going to return back to you what they can find and leave the rest blank. So let's go back for a second to our doctor's task. So what we want to do is take a list of university websites that we have and pull out every single name we can find of physicians, their addresses, email addresses, information that we can aggregate and then use to be helpful to them in some way for our business. So what we have here is a website page, inputs, outputs, that's gonna summarize. It tells us what the AI models are gonna do for us. We don't really need to know about the specifics. All we know is that we're giving the models the page we wanna pull a list from. And when we get back, we're gonna get all of the names we want. So first, I'm just gonna jump to the first example that I have pre-saved here, which is from a medical website, a list of physicians. I can click test, and in this case, things were saved already for this particular, so you can see here all the results displayed. We have 32 different names, perfectly formatted names, the website where they were found, so we can link back to it, their specialty, all the specialties were from a particular category, and then their phone numbers. What's great about this is any website we run, no matter what the format is, here's a completely different one. We can run this list in. The model's gonna work for a second, find everything it can, get everything in the same format, and then spit back to us every single one of the names that it can find. The power of this is not running site by site, but it allows us to take a list of sites. Phone numbers weren't available here, so it's gonna include the column but leave it blank. Once we have this task running, we can take a list of sites and run a data set all at once. So I can click upload run data, and what that'll take me to is our data sets page. We don't have any data sets yet, and what data sets are is the starting point for us building out a large amount of data. We were just testing the task page by page. Now we want to run a number of websites at the time. So I have a list of 5 websites saved here, which I'm going to upload, select the websites column, and submit the job. There's only 5 sites, so this is going to be fairly quickly. almost instant. But the beauty is you could upload a list of 10, 100, 1,000 websites, and it's going to find every single faculty member on all of those sites and then return us a data set perfectly formatted back. So we'll let this run for a second and then view the results. So once the job is done, we can click View Data, and we immediately have a searchable saved view of every single physician that we found. So each of these are from different websites, and we see the link from where they came from. We see the specialty, which is what we asked for, their title, phone number for those that we have, and the other ones left blank. We can then search for specific individuals and filter out items that we don't want to include, including searching through specialty. All of this is like immediately available on your datasets tab, and you see our version here. We want to rename the version, results from today, we can do that, and then run again with a new set of sites with more versions. We can even filter out some of these names, save it as a new version, and then run that on a new task. If you want information about how to take this to the next step, running tasks on top of names, finding out more information about people, and so on, and how you can chain together PromptLoop tasks, stay tuned for future videos. But I hope this was helpful, and I hope everyone tries it out today with their own list building and dataset creation operations. Thank you.